Hi everyone, this is Chandrasekhar, working as assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Today we are going to discuss the topic is interfaces. What actually the interface? See, this is a list of contents that are going to be discussed in the today's session. Defining an interface, declaring an interface, how you can declare an interface. After declaring an interface, how we can implement an interface and extending an interface, example programs on interface, and what are the new features that are added after 1.8 version of Java. That is also we are going to discuss. So these are the list of the contents, how you can define the interface, declaring an interface, implementing an interface, extending an interface, and as well as various example programs on interface. And finally, the new features are added in interface. The topic first we're going to see is how you can define an interface. Now, before going to defining an interface, you have to know what actually the interface. So it's like a blueprint of a class. Like your class contains members of a class, like variables as well as methods. Like your interface also have variables, but these variables are special, like nothing but there are static constants, and all the methods that are declared inside the interface are abstract methods. We are going to see what actually the abstract methods and why we can go for using the interface. It's a mechanism where you can achieve the abstraction. So abstraction here nothing but hiding the internal details, only implementation part you can see. Now interface contains only the abstract methods in interface. What is the meaning of an abstract method? The meaning of an abstract method is just you will declare the methods, you does not provide any body to that particular method. So that is called as an abstract method. Like you know about the abstract classes, where the abstract class contains both abstract methods as well as non-abstract methods. Abstract methods again there the thing but does not contains have any body, and only the method declaration, no definition. And a non-abstract methods nothing but it contains a logic method body. But the special here in the interface is the interface 100% contains abstract methods. Nothing but in interface whatever the methods you have to declare, that only contains method declaration, not have any method body. Yeah, so if you want to achieve multiple inheritance in Java, you can use the concept called interfaces. So by using the interface, the class will specify what actually a class must do, but how the class that will done it does not have. So meaning here is you have to specify what a class must do, but not how it does this. Now if you see about here, I written it's just syntactically similar to a class. Like how we will declare in a class, see here the syntax of class, class, name of the class, and it have various variables like in A, and it contains methods like I say an example void, add, and it contains some statements. You have one more method maybe called as void sub, and it also have statement. So this is a general syntax of class. So class followed by class name. Class contains instance variables, class also contains local variables, and whereas the method declarations here we return type as well as the name of the method without have any parameters, and type name of the method without have any parameters. But the see the specialty here is when you are declaring in methods in the class, you have to provide logic to particular methods. But you see here the interface is also look like syntactically similar to a class, but the difference is what? But the difference is it lacks an instance variables, and as well as whatever the methods that you are declared inside the interface that does not have any body. See here, without have any body, just you have to declare the method. We will see in the next slide how you can declare an interface, how you can declare the variables, how you can declare the methods without have any body. Now, like see here in an example, A is a class name and followed by a keyword called class. So we are specifying that you are declaring any class with the name of the class name by using the keyword called class. Like that, if you want to specify, if you want to declare an interface, you have to use a keyword called interface. So interface followed by interface name. You will see the syntax in the next slide. So interface can be defined within an interface keyword. So by using the interface keyword, you have to declare your interface as followed by interface name. See here the declaration, what actually the interface contains. Like in an example, a given class contains variables, instance variables, or maybe a local variables, and also the methods, other methods. Like your class contains various methods, like interfaces also consisting of various modifiers, and here you will use a keyword called interface, like I discussed in the second point, followed by name of the interface. If you want to specify more number of interfaces, like nothing but more number of parent interfaces, there you can use a comma separated list. By specifying the comma separated list, you can specify the various parent interfaces and the interface body. The interface body contains what? Variables, as well as the method declarations does not contain any body. So here, interface declaration consisting of what? Modifiers, and you have to declare the interface by using a keyword called interface, followed by the name of the interface, and it should be a comma separated list if you have to specify various parent interfaces and the body of the interface. Now here the important point we're going to discuss here is, we have various access specifiers. Like we have public access specifier, we have protected access specifier, we have private access specifier, and as well as default. Now here, out of all these four access specifiers or modifiers, so public access specifier, whenever you are specifying before an interface, means what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of that when you are specifying your access specifier public before in the front of interface? Mean that you can access that interface of any class in any package. So we will see what is the meaning of that. So the public access specifier will indicates that the interface can be used by any class. So when you are declared your interface as a public, that can be used by any class in any package. Irrespective of packages, you can use your interface in any class. That is the number one point. So here the key role played here is the public access specifier. Even though we have various other access specifiers, but public access specifier will indicate that the interface can be used in any of the class by using any package. Now, so what happened if I have not specified my interface as a public? Nothing. So if you do not specify your interface as a public, then the interface will be accessed only the classes that are defined in the same package as in the interface. Now see the differences of the first point as well as the second point. If you specify your interface as a public access specifier, then that interface can be used. That interface can be used by any class in any package. So here, can be used by any class in any package. Whenever you will use access specifier as public in the front of interface. But if you do not specify that your interface as a public, then the interface can be accessed only to the classes that are defined in the same package, not of any other packages as in the interface. So specifying the public interface or specifying you are not declaring any access specifier in front of the interface depends upon the requirements. So if you specify the public interface, public access specifier in front of the interface, you can access anywhere in any package. But when you does not specify access specifier as a public in front of the interface, you can access only the classes that are defined in the same package as in the interface. Now, the important point here is we have two keywords when you are dealing with the classes as well as an interface. One is extends and another one is implement. When you are going to use extend, when you are going to use implements, so there will be a difference. So when a class is extending another class, where you can go for use an extend keyword. But whenever any class as implementing an interface, so you can use a keyword called implement. So the point here is an interface can extend, an interface can extend other interfaces. It is also possible for extending an interfaces. We will see in the later. Like how your class can extend another class. What is the syntax of a class can extend another class? Assume that I have a class called ABC where I have various methods. Now here see, I have a class XYZ. So here I am using a keyword called extends ABC. So here see, ABC is a type of the class. XYZ is also a type of the class. So here I am using extend keyword. In between, it is a child class and this one will be the parent class. So both are will be the classes where I can use for extend keyword. So you can extend, use this keyword extend in between the interfaces also. We will see in the next coming slides. But you can also extend an interfaces just as your class can extend or your subclass of an another class. So that is an important point. So here two keywords, extends as well as an implements keyword. Now, the important point here is, if compared with the third as well as the fourth, a class, like I given an example, a class can extend only one of other class, but interface can extend any number of interfaces. A class cannot extend more than number of one class. Like an example, class A or say B extends A comma B, A comma C comma D. Assume that you are already declared class A. Assume that you are already declared class C. Assume that you are already declared class C. Here class B will be play a vital role. It is a child class. And all are extends after right hand side, we can say as parent classes. So it is not possible. A class can extends only one class at a time. A class can extends only one class at a time. It cannot extend more than one class. But apart from this, an interface can extends any number of interfaces. We will see the syntax. So interface declaration includes comma separated list of all the interfaces that are going to extend. How? Just write the interface, name of the interface, followed by extends, then followed by interface name 1, interface name 2, interface name 3. All are interface name 1, 2, 3. If you want to specify, just specify with a comma separated list. So the points here we discussed is there will be an access specifier called as a public. If you specify public access specifier, then your interface can be accessed by any classes in any package. If it does not specify access specifier as a public, then the interface can be accessible only to the classes that are defined in the package or in the same package as the interface. And interface can extend other interfaces just like how your class can extend other of subclasses. And interfaces or class can extend only one of other class. So a class can extend only one of other class, but an interface can extend any number of interfaces. If you want to specify, if you want to declare more number of interfaces, if you want to declare more number of interfaces, just use a comma separated list of all the interfaces that it will extends. But the point here is how you can declare an interface. Up to now we have discussed about the what is interface, how you can define the interface, how what access specifier you have to use. If you are use public access specifier, what will happen? If it does not do the access specifier, what will happen? But the important point here is how you can declare an interface. So here, use a keyword called interface to declare an interface. Then it will provide total abstractions, mean that whatever the methods that you are declared inside the interfaces that have empty body, does not have any logic, and all the fields, nothing but all the variables, are by defaultly public, static and final. You cannot change the value, you cannot change the variable value that is declared inside the interface. So if you want to achieve, it will provide total abstraction, meaning that all the methods that you are declared inside the interface that have only empty method does not have any body, only method declaration does not have any logic, and the fields, nothing but the variables what you are going to declare inside the interfaces, are by defaultly public, static and as well as final. So a class, whichever the class that is going to implements an interface, must implement all the methods that are declared inside the interface. Suppose you are declared 2 or 3 methods in an interface. So whichever class that is going to implement that particular interface must and should provide logic, or must and should implement all the methods that are declared inside the interface. See here the general syntax of interface, how it will be, we'll discuss deeper. See here, like previously we discussed, there is a keyword called interface and followed by interface name. Don't write capital letter I. There is no capital letter I interface declaration. There is a keyword called interface that should be with a small letter interface, followed by name of the interface. What interface contains? Members. Who are the members? Variables and methods. Both these are the members of your interface. See here, constant fields. You have to declare constant field. Like I said, all the fields that are declared inside the interfaces, all the fields that are declared inside the interfaces are constant fields. And methods. All the methods that are declared inside the interface are abstract. Abstract methods. Nothing but does not have any logic. Then close the interface. So two things here. Interface contains two things. Members, we can say, variable fields, constant fields, as well as the methods. Nothing but all the methods that are declared inside the interface are abstract methods. The question arises, why I can use interface in Java, or why can use Java interface? So 3 points. See here the figure. If you want to achieve abstraction, nothing but just implementation details will be, total details are will be hidden, only implementation part. By using the interface, you can achieve multiple inheritance, how we will discuss with an example program. So you can support the functionality of multiple inheritance, where Java does not support multiple inheritance directly. So it can be used to achieve loose coupling. So these are the three uses of Java interface. See here the main three reasons why you can use interface is, they are given below. Like if you want to achieve abstraction, go for use interface. If you want to achieve multiple inheritance, or by using the interface you can support the functionality of multiple inheritance, and it can be used to achieve the loose coupling. Now here, coming to how you can declare an interface. What is the general format? Or what is the syntax of declaring an interface? See here, the full-fledged general format of syntax of declaring members of interface. See here, interface, name of the interface. Here, I declare type. Here, type nothing but data type, any data type. And method name 1 is the name of the method that is defined by the user, called as a user-defined method name. And the parameter list. and that method will be enclosed with a semicolon. That's very important. So here see, we will use a keyword called interface followed by interface name, followed by interface name. Now we will declare a method. As I said, all the methods that are declared in the interface are abstract methods. See here, I does not return any logic here. So now second method, again data type, name of the method, data type, name of the method, and a parameter list, if any. Important point here is you have to enclose with a semicolon. You have to enclose with semicolon. Now, who are the other members of an interface? Declaring a variables like that, you can declare any number of methods, but important point here is you have to specify the type, name of the method, parameter list if any, and but that should be end with semicolon. Now, you have to declare the variables. Like I said, the variables that are declared inside the interface by defaultly public static final. Here see, again type, nothing but data type, variable name one, value. You have to specify the value because that value is constant entire program, value cannot change. That is the reason why you have to initialize the variables that are declared inside the interface in a single stretch. Now again, there is no limit. You can declare n number of variables in an interface. So type, name of the variable, here I written in n number of variables you can write, and value, you have to specify the value, then close the interface. So this is the ultimate final format of a syntax of declaring an interface. So here the points. So these are the points. If you see, all the methods that are declared inside the interface have a no bodies, but the important point here is they will end with semicolon after the parameter list. If you want to specify the parameter list, that is based on the requirement of your program. And all the methods that are essentially abstract methods, no logic at all, no body. Interface may also include variables, but whenever you are declaring an interface, variables in the interface that must be final, static, and you have to initialize with a value. You have to initialize with a constant value. So both interface contains methods, interface contains variables, but the variables declared inside the interface are by defaultly final, static, and that are initialized with a constant value. That are instant with a constant value. Now, when you are declaring public interface, by defaultly, all the members, nothing but the methods, nothing but the variables, are by implicitly public. So when you declare your interface as a public interface, like an example, public interface, I written IT1 is the name of the interface. So by defaultly, whatever the methods you have written inside the interface, all are public by defaultly. Here I not specified public void add. Here I not specified public data type variable name is equal to value. By defaultly, when you specify the public, your interface as a public, all the members are implicitly as the public. Now here we declare methods. But what you will do after declaring a methods, you have to implement. So beginning of the slides, I said extends and implements both are used here when you are doing, when you are working with an interface. But how can you implement? How can you implement? So there is a keyword called implement. So a class can implement an interface, meaning that it has to provide the complete set of methods that are defined inside the interface. Suppose you have declared 4 methods in an interface, you have to provide complete implementation about that 4 methods. If you have declared 10 methods in an interface, your class which is going to implement that particular interface, that have to provide body to all the 10 methods. So any number of classes may implement an interface, not by using the single class. You can write any number of classes that are going to may implement an interface. One class can implement any number of interfaces. So by using one class, you can implement any number of interfaces, and each and every class is free to determine all the details of its implementation. So whichever class is going to implement an interface, it has to provide implementation of all the methods. So implementation relation is written by using the keyword called, here again there is a keyword called implements. By using the implements, then you can implement all the methods that are declared inside the interface by using the class. If you see the general format, how you can write an implement. See here I written access, and nothing but public or a default, class name, extends, super class name, name of the parent class. Now see the important point here is, it is going to implement interface 1, interface 2, interface n. So one class may implement any number of interfaces. So that is the important point here is, a class can implement any number of interfaces. Any number of classes may implement an interface. Not by using only the single class, you can implement that particular interface. A class can implement any number of interfaces. We will see with an example program. So if a class has implement several interfaces, you have to separate it with a comma. Like previous slide, I shown here this comma separated list. If your class has implementing several interfaces, so they are separated with comma. So if your class implements two interfaces that are declared with the same method name, so if you have an interface IT1 have a method name called show, again another interface name IT2 again the same method like a show, then the same method will be used by the clients of either interface. So the methods that are going to implement an interface, that must be declared as in public. Very important point here is, the whatever the method that are going to implement in a particular class of the method that are declared in the interface, you have to declare that method as public. I will show you with an example program. And the important point here is, the type signature, whichever the method you are going to implementing in that particular class, that implementing method must match exactly the type signature that is specified in the interface definition. Very important point here is, so the type signature should match the type signature that you are declared in the interface definition. I will show you with an example program. See here, what is the relationship? I said, meaning there are two keywords, like one is an extends keyword, another is an implement keyword. See here, a class can extends one class. So where you can use extends keyword. So the class can extends another class. A class can implements a number of interfaces. Here we are using keyword called implement. See here, class. But see the top one, class interface. Whenever you are dealing with a class and interface, here then use a keyword called implements. If you write extends, class extends interface, it's not valid. It's throw an error. So class will implement an interface. So there is also concept called, you can extend an interface. You can extend an interface. So here see, interface extends another interface. So interface extends another interface. So very important diagram. Class can extend one class. A class can implement a number of interfaces. An interface can extends another interface. So here two keywords, extends if you use in between classes, valid. Extends keyword in between interfaces, valid. If you use extends keyword in between class as well as an interface, not valid. When will you use class interface, then you can go for implements the all the methods. So the figure given below is, a class can extends another class, an interface can extends another interface, but important point here is, the middle diagram, the class can implement another interface. A class can implement another interface. See a small example program. In the example, I have written an interface called printable. See, interface name of the interface. Name of the interface is what? Printable interface. Now, it contains one method. Like I said, all the methods that are declared inside the interface are abstract methods. Now see, written void print. Void print with a semicolon. I did not written any parameters. Okay, based on the program. Here, written a void and a print. Name of the method is what? Name of the method is print. I have to implement. I have to provide body. In the next coming class, whichever that class is going to implement that particular interface. Now see the important point here is this one. Class followed by class name. In our example, the class name is A. Not extend. See here, implements. Implements printable. Implements printable. What is a printable? This is an interface. This is an interface. So, right side interface, left hand side class. So, in between the keyword you have to use is implements, like a figure as shown in the previous slide. So, a class can implement an interface, and the methods that are going to implement in that particular class, you must and should declare, public. Public. So, here I written the same method here, public, void, print. And I written some statement, system.out.println, some hello. Then main method, I am creating an object of the child class, the class which is going to implement that. A object name is equal to new A, object creation, the statement, object creation. And now I am calling the print method. How can I call? By using an object name, obj.print. So there's a print method. Here the print method, it will go inside and it will print system.out.println hello. So point here is, we have declared an interface, name of the interface, we declared the method called print method that does not have any body, that does not have any logic, and I am going to implement that interface, or I am providing the logic, that particular method, whichever the class is going to implement that particular interface. So what is a syntax, or what is the statement? Class A implements printable. What is printable? Name of the interface. What is A? Name of the class. What is implements? It is a keyword used in between the class as well as going to implement a particular interface. And the method, whatever you are declared, that must and should declared as public. So here in our example, printable interface have only one method. So that one method you had written as a public void print method, and just I written one statement, print statement, main method, this statement is object creation, and I'm calling that particular method. What is a method? This is a method, print method. So obj.print. So then output will have hello. So this is a general example of by using the interface. Let's check another example. See here, I have an interface called drawable. I have an interface called as drawable. So by first user interface declaration, first user declared an interface like interface, name of the interface. In our example, the name of the interface is drawable. Okay. It has one method called draw. It has one method called draw. So interface drawable has a method called draw. Now see the implementation by the second user. The implementation by the second user. I have a class called a rectangle. I have to implement. I have to provide body to the method that is declared inside the interface is called as draw. So I am using the method keyword is implements drawable. Implements drawable. So implements before name of the class, implements after name of the interface. Valid. Okay, now I am writing the method. Make sure that method should be a public void draw. So the same draw method you write down, you have to provide logic, but important point here is make that method as public. Then I written system.out.println. I am drawing the rectangle. That is by second user. Now, I have one more class, like n number of classes can implement the same interface. N number of classes So in our example, I written one class called rectangle. I written one more class called circle. See here, class circle implements drawable. So again the same. Implements before name of the class. Implements after name of the interface. So implements before name of the class. Implements after name of the interface. So the same method I written. See here, public void draw. So single method I am implementing, I am providing body in other class in different way. So public void draw, again I written one print statement drawing circle. So I need to call the same method that is declared inside the interface. So one method I have implemented in the rectangle class, same method I have implemented in circle class. Now how can I call this draw method? How can I call this draw method? Now see here, main class, by using by the third user. Class, general class, I am testing an interface, name of the class. Now see here the main method, public static void main. Now here see, this line will be the very important. Drawable D is equal to new circle. Drawable D is equal to new circle. What is actually drawable? Is an interface. One more important point here is, you cannot create object of an interface. Like you cannot create object of your abstract classes. Like that you cannot create object for interface. But what is this line? You can create reference. You can create reference of an interface. So here new circle. New circle is what? Creating an object of circle class. Creating an object of circle class. So D dot draw. What is D? A reference of interface which is going to implements by using the circle class. So when I say D dot draw, here in rectangle class draw method, circle class draw method, which draw method will call? So we are creating an object for circle method, so circle class, then that particular method draw will be called here. So D is a reference of drawable like an interface and new circle. So D dot draw. So in D dot draw, what is D? Reference of interface and new circle is what? Creating an object. So when you say D dot draw, so drawing circle will be print. So point here is, one n number of classes can implement, n number of classes can implement that interface, n number of classes, not by using the single class. But the point here is, you cannot create object, you cannot create an object for an interface, but you can create reference, you can create reference of an interface. Now like previously we discussed about how you can extend an interface, it's also possible. Before that we discussed about the implements keyword. So there is a keyword also extends. So if you see the diagram, interface extends another interface. So here interface can extends another interface. So one interface may inherit another interface. So that the syntax will be the same, like how you can extends one class, the syntax is same as how you can extends one class. See here in our example, interface, name of the interface, interface, name of the interface. I have one method called method 1. I have a method called method 1 because the interface method does not have any logic. And now see, this is the first interface. Now see the second interface, interface, second interface name. Now see here, no implements. I am using a keyword called extends, because before extends, name of the interface, after extends, name of the interface, maybe the parent interface. So here the extends keyword. So how you are using extends? Either you are using in between classes, or you are using in between interfaces. When you are using implements, or you are using in between classes, or in between class or interface, you have to make sure that where you are using that particular keyword, either maybe extends or maybe a implement. See here, an interface can extend another interface. What is the syntax? Interface, name of the interface. I am using the keyword extends, another name of the interface. then method 2. So my interface 2 contains method 2, my interface 1 contains method 1. So the syntax is similar, same as classes as well as and interfaces. So based on this, we will discuss one example program, how you can extend an interface. Remember this syntax, this one is very important. So interface, name of the interface, extending another interface, the parent interface. Whenever a class implements an interface that will inheriting all another interface, so it must provide implementation for all the particular methods that are defined in the interface inheritance chain. Suppose like you declared 4 or 5 methods in an interface, whichever class is going to implement that particular interface, that would provide implementation for all the methods. Suppose see an example program, extending an interface, how you can extend an interface. Consider there is an interface called A and B. Consider an interface called A and B. Now, interface A. What is A? First interface name. Name of the interface is what? A. It contains 2 methods. First method is void Meth1. I written a Meth1 as a name of the method. Void Meth2. The second method name. I am closing this. I didn't written any variables based on the requirement of the program. I just declare 2 methods, because we know the method that are declared inside the interfaces are abstract methods. Does not have any logic. Now see. How can you extend? How can you extend? Or how can you use the extend keyword in between 2 interfaces? Now see, interface B. What is B? Assume that it may be a child. Extends A. What is A? Parent A. So whenever you are saying extending A, so all the methods that are going to be inherited in the inheritance B. Now inheritance B or interface B contains its own method called Meth3. So how many methods total? There are 3 methods. The first method is Meth1. The second method is Meth2. Third method is Meth3. So whichever class is going to implement that particular interface, it must provide implementation for all the methods that are defined within the interface inheritance chain. So interface inheritance chain means what? Interface A contains 2 methods. Interface B contains 1 method. Total how many methods? 3 methods. So your class must and should provide implementation for all the methods that are declared in the inheritance interface or interface inheritance chain. So see, in the next example, you have to provide logic to 3 methods, void Meth1, void Meth2. Now see here, I written one class called my class, that is my class name. That class must and should implement all the methods of A and B, interface inheritance chain. So now see, class, name of the class, implements B, because we written interface B extends A. So inheriting all the properties of A. So just written here, implements B. So what is my class? Name of the class. What is B? Name of the interface. Now see the keyword implements, valid. So before class, after name of the interface. Now I am providing body to all the methods. How many methods? 3 methods I am providing body. Now see, important point here is you have to write public. So public void Meth1. Public void Meth1, I am providing logic. Public void Meth2, I am providing logic. Just I am writing a small single line statement, print statement. Now Meth3 void, one more print statement. So here see, first method, second method, third method. For all the methods, I have provided body. I have provided logic. Here logic, nothing but a single statement. Three methods, I have provided logic. So point here is, so my class, so whichever class is going to implement that particular interface, must and should provide, implement all the methods that are declared inside the interface. Now, See here, the final class. How can you create an object? Class, name of the class. Class, name of the class. Main method. Main method. Now I am creating an object of my class. OB is the name of the object. New my class. So object creation statement. How can you create an object? This is an object creation statement. My class is the name of the class. OB is an object name, that is user defined name. Any name you can give. New my class. Now see, I am calling the three methods because my class has implemented three methods, Meth1, Meth2, Meth3. So I am calling the three methods. Object name dot Meth1. Object name dot Meth2. Object name dot Meth3. So like three methods, I have three methods I have need to call. So like this, you can extend. You can extend an interface. But point here is, whichever class is going to implement that particular interface, it must provide implementation for all the methods that are declared inside the interface. You have to fulfill the interface inheritance chain. So there are some new features that are added after 1.8 version of the Java. The main background story related about the interface is what? It contains abstract methods. Okay. But in 1.8 version, they are added some new features. What are the new features that are added in Java Development Kit in 1.8 version? So prior to JDK 8, before that, interfaces could not define any implementation. Like interface methods, all are abstract methods. But there are some new features are added. That is nothing but default implementation. That is nothing but a default implementation. There is a default method implementation for interface methods. But the backend creation of interface is what? It contains only abstract methods. So they are not disturbed any concept or point related to about the interface, but they are added some new features. What are the new features? One is they are add a default implementation for interface method. So this default implementation has a special use and it does not affect the main intention behind the interfaces. What are the main intention behind the interfaces? It does not contain any logic. All methods are of abstract method. Suppose if you want to add or need to add a new function in an existing interface, then you can go for using the default implementation. So whenever adding new function for an existing interface, obviously the old code will not work and the classes that have not implemented those new functions. So for that, with the help of default implementation, you have to give a default body for the newly added function. We have newly added function. Let us see the example. Let us see an example. I have an interface called IN1. I have an interface called IN1, name of the interface. So I said, what are the variables that you are declared inside the interface are by defaultly public, final and static. Now see here. Final int a, I am specifying the value of a is 10. Value of a is 10. Now see, void display. What is the main intention behind the interface is? Interface contains variables as well as the methods. The method that are declared inside the interface are abstract methods. So sometimes you may also add some default implementation for that particular method. So use a keyword, this new feature. This is added in 1.8 version or JDK 8. So default, you just specify default void display. Then specify one statement. Specify one print statement. So a class that implements an interface. So it's the same syntax. Class, name of the class. Class, name of the class. Implements IN1. What is IN1? What is IN1? Name of the interface. What is IN1? Name of the interface. So implements before what? Name of the class. Now main method, I am creating an object, test class t is equal to new test class t dot display. But interface methods are abstract methods, but this new feature I added, just specify, use a keyword called default, use a special called default. So I am creating an object, I am calling t dot display. Object name dot display. So what is it will display? It will display hello. This is a new feature added in the 1.8 version of the Java. There is one more feature added. This is one more new feature added in an interface. Is in you can define static methods also in interface, so which can be called independently without creating any object. In previous example, we discussed calling the particular method by creating an object. But this is also one more new feature added by using you can create static methods. For the static methods, no need to create an object, no need to call by using the object name. Automatically or independently, they can call. So these methods are not inherited. So inheritance is not possible. Now see here, another example program that can show the methods that are JDK 1.8 words onwards. Interface, again, name of the interface. I declared a variable, final int a is equal to 10. Then display, previous example, I written a statement called default. Now another feature is added in 1.8 version. You have to declare your method as a static. Now just a print statement. Now class, name of the class. Implements interface. Now implements after name of the interface. Implements before name of the class. So then main method, in previous example I created object of test class. By using that object of test class, I have called the method default void display. But here I written a method display that is type of static. So the static methods in interfaces which can be called independently without have any creation of objects. Now see, INY is what? Interface name dot display. I have not created test class obj is equal to new test class. I not created, because for static methods no need to create an object, directly it will call. So by IN1 is the name of their interface display. So IN1 dot display, it will print hello. So these are the new two features that are added in Java 1.8 version onwards. So questions, what is the difference between class as well as an interface? So what is the difference between abstract class as well as an interface? What is actually the interface? And explain briefly about the interfaces with its syntaxes with an example program. And what are the new features that are added in JDK 1.8 version? So that is, one is default implementation. By creating an object, you are providing a logic, you are calling that with an object name. And another feature is you are declared your method as static. For the static method, no need to create an object. Independently, that will be called by using the name of the interface. So, thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.